Hello, and welcome back to another episode. Today, I am following up on a tip, a comment left on my previous video, where I was exploring my love of the Blair Witch Project movie, essentially telling me how great the Blair Witch game is. And I have heard about this game when it came out. I was very interested in it. And I'm also very interested in actually the team who developed this game, Bloober Team. For example, Layers of Fear is a game I very much enjoy. And of course, there's more recent. Is it The Observer, starring Rutger Hauer? Howard, always get his name on the that Bloober Team have produced that I want to play. But today, they are playing in the world of the Blair Witch Project, and that is very exciting. It's sending shivers down my spine in anticipation at the very thought of it. And I suppose it makes me wonder, why hasn't this happened sooner? This Lost in the Woods.
In local news, there is still no sign of the 9-year-old Peter Shannon, who went missing on Saturday afternoon. The missing boy was last seen wearing a green t-shirt and a Baltimore Crows cap. Local authorities are organizing a search party in the Black Hills Forest. This marks the latest in a series of disappearances dating back to 1994, when a group of students ventured into the woods near Burkittsville, never to be seen again.
Blimey. But this whole scenario, it has always been begging for some sort of exploration in the game form. In many ways, I'm amazed it hasn't happened sooner. But here we are. Tap RB to get your phone. Oh, look at that phone! Very 90s, okay.
Hey, Alice.
Jess, hey. Yeah, it's good to hear from you. I didn't think you'd call.
Yeah, well, neither did I, to be honest. Guess we're both full of surprises.
It's a very narrow road.
So what are you up to?
Did you hear about the missing kid?
For America,
joining the search.
Oh, wow. Okay. You think that's a good idea?
Why wouldn't it be?
You know why. You know what? Never mind. You're right. Maybe I shouldn't have called.
No, Jess, wait. I'm glad you did. Listen, I'm almost there. I'll call you later, okay?
All right. Careful.
Ominous foreshadowing. And a dog. A lovely dog, which my understanding is that you can pet the dog in this game, which is very pleasing. Peter Shannon missing. Very similar poster to the to that which is used to alert people to the missing students. Here we are arriving. So, incidentally, I'm already loving this. I haven't even started playing and I'm loving it.
Come on, Bullet. Let's see if we can find a way to contact Sheriff Lanning.
Because, as I say, I think I loved the idea of investigating. Select fur color. Okay, well, let's go for the same sort of look as my dog. Color. Red? Do you want red? Green? I suppose the point is to be visible, isn't it? So I'll go for green. An eye color. There we go. Okay. Good boy. And the first thing we have to change is also the settings there, I'm afraid. I am an inverted camera type person. For view. No, that's not it. Controls, of course. There we go. Invert that. I always loved the idea of investigating the missing students originally, and that's the whole point of why I ended up getting that dossier following my friend in
school. Started without us, huh?
Giving us that presentation. Okay. And so the idea of actually doing this, you know, in a game is very exciting.
Let's find this kid.
Anthony,
been through enough already.
Stopped pissing your pants every time someone mentions the witch and decided to show up. Check the trunk. There's a walkie-talkie in there for you. I'm also leaving you a photo of the kid we're looking for. Call Sheriff Lanning on Channel 2 once you're ready to join us, Greg. Okay, cool. Oh. That would have been much easier. let's open that. And walkie-talkie.
Sorry, Anthony. First come, first served. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll call Lanning once I'm in the forest.
Okay, off we go. It's very atmospheric. I'm not even in the woods yet. This is the parking area. I wonder if the police are going to get lost. You know, obviously I'm going to have an experience.
Oh, looks like they have the whole forest covered.
Yeah, Richmond Lopez, Culver Bridge, Young Lim, Spencer Rocks, Prince Finley, Tanner, Costa, Logging Camp, Bonham, Ingram, Peters, Solbono, or Solbon Wiggins, 9 years, 4 foot, four tall, Baltimore Crows Camp. There's a mug, world's best sheriff. Okay. Investigation report. 1435, officer was notified of disappearance of Peter Shannon by his mother, Laura Shannon. The initial investigating officer established the following. 1. Peter was last seen heading to his friend's house around 11:20 a.m. on September the 15th, 1996. Mrs. Shannon has been unable to locate him ever since. 2. Peter has a history of previous attempts to run away from home. And 3. There are no eyewitnesses to the moment of Peter's disappearance. 1530, initial search yielded no results. Due to Shannon's age, the risk has been reassessed as high. 1700, an order to organize a search in Black Hills Forest, where the boy was found during one of his previous escapes, is given. Oh, he's already been to the woods. Now that's interesting. He could be under the influence of the witch. Was given by Sheriff Emmett Lanning, has been appointed to head the operation. Signed Oliver Matthewson, investigating officer. Okay. Good to know. Oh, okay, cool. Why can't I store my well, that's weird. I can't move anymore. Backpack. Oh, okay, right. So I can have a look at things in the backpack. Okay, that's good to know. Thank you.
They came well prepared.
They did. Tents, missing flyers. Cool. Guess I better keep that if I can. And off we go.
You found something, buddy?
Oh.
We're not leaving that laying around, right, boy?
Oh, cool. We're gonna tidy up the forest. I like it. Cool. Thank you. Good boy. I like the sniffing noises. Okay, I can't put it off any longer. Let's go into the woods, I guess. Let's go into the woods. No cycling. The witch doesn't like it. Oh, what's that?
What is this?
Idol. It's a bit rough for an idol, but okay. That's just my anthropological snobbery throwing through. Come on, boy. Let's go. Oh, God. This is just... Now, this, actually... Do you remember I was telling you last week about the woods near the Gop, near Trelawnid in Denbighshire? Denbighshire, actually. Anyway, in North... Back home. this is kind of how it feels back there. This sort of denseness of the forest. And I imagine it's only going to get more atmospheric.
Let's go find this kid.
It's a strange one, actually, in place, that place for Leonard, because it's on the way to lots of different places. You have to drive through it to get to it. Elves anywhere. And it tends to be those places that you have to go through to get to other places that have these little pockets, I think, of atmospheric woodland and deep leaf litter like that. You rolling in fox poop?
No point in waiting any longer.
Okay.
Let's call Lanning.
Set to channel 2. Okay. Cool.
Ellis to base. Did you copy?
Ellis, what are you doing out here?
Joining the search party.
Ellis, if you think you got some obligation to be here, you don't. I mean, I know it's his brother and all.
Sir, I'm here to help. That's all there is to it. Bullets with me. If he catches the scent, he'll lead us straight to the kid.
You got a point there. You think you're up for it?
Health issues?
They're not gonna be a problem?
Sir, I'm not gonna screw this up. Not this time.
Well, alright then. Just stay in the rear. Make sure we haven't missed anything.
Roger that. Over now.
Now, it may sound really silly, but
time to get to work.
It's these sorts of patches of ground where the stones are falling out of a higher erosion of soil, this kind of thing, that just, it makes it feel real. I mean, I know it's a way of bounding the play space, as it were, but again, it's all very familiar. But yes, I grew up exploring the woods, actually in various places. I used to very much enjoy going up in the woods in the Vale of Clwyd, up on Graigvawr, a mountain nearby to where our house is in Prestatyn. But also actually Delamere Forest as well in Cheshire was a place we'd go quite often. And again, that's less similar to this. This is unmanaged woodland. The trees are leaning, the canopy is getting a bit too thick for its own good. The undergrowth is thick, but I remember in particular. I was just reminded we once built a den in Delamere Forest where there was a fern in particular that we were trying to make a fern roof on top of some wood sticks that we were using as a frame. Tap LB.
Come here, boy.
Oh, nice. Oh, then you can hold it to give him an order. Can you? This is Billy, your right-hand dog. Listen to his barking and watch his body language. He'll be the first to alarm you of any trouble, but he'll need your help to deal with it. Remember, the way you treat him can affect his behavior later in the game. Stay close to him. Prolonged loneliness can affect your mental state. Okay, cool. Seek pets. Stay close. Stay reprimand. Oh, okay. Press LB to call him back. Excellent, okay. Well, I guess good boy. Choose the seek command, which is seek. Okay.
Come on, look around, boy. Yeah, lead on, buddy.
Cool. Yeah, so we're making a den. We've made the frame out of fallen logs and branches and things. And I was pulling up ferns to use as the roof. And the thing about fern is that obviously the leaves are very soft. and good in that sense for a roof, because they also
deflect
water.
We're looking for Peter, not the search party, buddy.
Yeah. Oh, can we pick up the water bottle? No, I don't think so. Where have you gone, boy? Where have you gone? Oh, man. Forest.
We're taking a detour. Spencer thinks he saw something. It's probably just a raccoon.
Oh, they are.
But, yeah.
I told you it was not a raccoon.
Great. A bear, then.
Okay. Anyway, I was grabbing Fern. I actually very much like this stuff here.
Chief, we're done checking the bridge. Nothing here.
Ow! Fucking brambles! You guys know these woods are cursed, right? You don't leave by nightfall, you might not leave at all.
Then let's find that kid and get out of here.
That's helpful.
Now cut the chatter and focus on the search.
Yep, it was a raccoon.
Logging area is clear.
Good job.
Anyway, I was grabbing Fern, much like this stuff here.
Wow, do you guys see that old tree? It's the creeps. You know, back during the Revolutionary War, there was this witch. She kidnapped the local children, suck on their blood and whatnot. When they finally caught her, they hanged her on one of those trees.
Nice.
Ingram, do you ever shut up?
Indeed, do they ever shut up?
Check the hill, Ingram.
Oh.
Got it.
A photo? What the hell?
What the hell, indeed?
Is it even possible for a kid to get this far?
Not on his own.
Did anyone check that place?
What place? Oh, that place.
They're talking about the house.
Ever since they found those tapes, it's the first place we looked.
All right, boys, let's talk in more
searching. Oh, okay, boy. Where are you? Oh, what have you found? Anything interesting?
Hey, you got anything?
Yeah, just some garbage.
Careful there, Caldwell.
God damn, it's slippery here.
Oh. Come on, boy, where are you? There you are. Come on. So I was grabbing Fern, and unfortunately, even though the leaves are soft, the stems are extremely solid, and actually are quite sharp when you give them a good yank. So I sliced my hand open.
Bullet, fetch!
And it was bleeding everywhere in the forest, and that was really actually oddly... invocative,
what'd
shall we
find?
Say? You know,
let
like,
me see.
Oh.
Aren't you a handsome boy?
Cap. Good boy.
Leave it, buddy. Now's not the time.
Just the best cap. Well done.
Baltimore crows. That's Peter's cap.
Yeah.
Good boy.
He's covered in mud.
We need to hurry. Can you follow the scent?
Uh huh. Sniff.
Come here, boy. Sniff. Good boy. Now show him. Ellis to base. I found Peter's cap.
You did? Well, great job, Ellis. Just stay where you are. We'll join up with you and keep searching from there.
Negative. Bullet picked up a scent. I'm not risking him losing it. I'll keep you posted. Over and out.
Yeah, so there's blood on the fern, blood on the floor, and I remember thinking, well, even as a kid, you know, obviously growing up in Wales, you learn stories about the woods and
Bullet,
the forest.
Wait up!
And I remember thinking it felt like a witch's, you know, witch's ritual or something. Maybe calling the fairies, you know, this kind of thing.
Damn it!
Oh no.
What if I pull it back up there?
This is quite clever, actually, they're getting you off track. And also all this sort of stuff. I mean, this hill, for example, is very similar to the sort of thing that you see in the Blair Witch Project in the film where they're sort of talking about I like shortcuts that don't climb hills, aren't mountainous. I like the way that they're managing space in this game.
Where the hell is he?
It feels like you could go off in any direction for, you know, forever.
No, not
but
now.
But clearly you couldn't. Oh dear. Are we having trouble?
Come get a grip, Ellis. We've gotten this far. And I'm giving up now.
Oh no. When he gets stressed, clearly he, well.
Calm down, Ellis. Everything's fine. It's all in your head.
Concrete bollard. I like this. I like the idea that the forest and the witch will play on your fears.
Decided to show up.
Yeah.
Don't leave me like this, okay, buddy? I can't be alone out here. What is it, boy? Did you find something? Ah, so we're still on Peter's trail. Good. Yeah, lead on, buddy.
Okay.
Heel!
No, should I pet him? There you go. Good boy.
Yeah, good dog.
Aww. You can almost feel that hot, sweaty tongue, can't you? Oh, I unlocked an achievement. Good boy. Is that me being a good boy for unlocking the achievement? Or just the name of the achievement? Okay, what have you found, boy? Come on. Don't send me careering down a hill again. Okay, oh yeah, I got a text message, didn't I? Yep. Answer.
Hey. Hey, Jess.
Ellis, is everything all right? You don't sound so hot.
No, it's, I'm fine. It's, under control.
It doesn't sound like it. Ellis, maybe you should...
No, I said I'm fine!
No, not
yeah,
good.
Of course you are.
Now listen, I think I saw something. I gotta go. Call you later. I'm sorry, Jess.
I like the way everything has changed. This, sort of, this is the way that the forest changes, though, around the back of the Gop Hill, or the Gop Inchland. You have this sort of sense that the daylight has disappeared. Oh, except there's more noise here. There's more animal noise in this section of the woods than there is around the back of Chelanid. Fantastic. Anyway, I need to check my text message. Now. No, that's my radio. Navigate. All history messages. Oh, Jess, well, everything's going well. Give me a call.
Said call.
I just had a bit of an argument, so I'll call a bit later. What's that? Yeah. Okay. The sound effects are brilliant. Especially playing with headphones. But it's the way that leaves and trees and, you know, the woods can muffle sound. The way that it can deaden sound is so important.
Is that a... campsite?
Campsite indeed. Camera.
Looks pretty beat up, but yeah, I think it still works.
Me.
maybe you should...
No, I'm fine.
Oh, dear.
I'll deal with it.
Oh, Ellis.
I just need a little more time.
Ellis, what you need is help.
I could have managed.
No.
Ellis, I can't do this anymore.
You can't just think your way
what?
Out of it.
What is it this time? Steven. What, I wasn't smiling enough? Didn't say I love you for 5 fucking minutes?
Jesus Christ, Ellis. Do you even hear yourself?
Yeah, I can hear myself just fine. And I can see the way you look at me. Like I'm a fucking loser. You know, sick little puppy for you to look after.
Oh, why, Ellis?
Get over yourself, well. Ellis. Be a man for once.
Well, yeah, there it is.
There it is.
I hope you can figure it out, Ellis. I hope you can finally forgive yourself. I tried to help you, but I just can't be around you anymore.
Go ahead. Get out. Leave me the fuck alone.
What's that doing on the camera, though? Oh, nice. That's your phone screen on the TV. Oh, dear.
Come on, be a man.
Wow.
Ellis, you got my message. You, want to see me, sir?
Better yet. I want to introduce you to someone. Bullet, meet your new partner. He's been through a lot, just like you.
What? Sir, I can't.
Oh, you got something else going on right now? Just take the damn dog, Ellis.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
It's a very clean carpet for a sheriff's office. Oh.
What did I? Did I pass out? Boy.
Poor dog,
oh,
I'm
shit.
Wondering what the heck's going on with this guy.
It's pitch black. Oh, I must have blacked out for hours.
Oh, no, I'm in the woods at night. That's when the curse begins. Where's the... Was I in the tent?
It's damaged, but relatively new. Probably not something a 9-year-old could set up.
Whose is this? Where are you, boy? There you are. I love the... Oh, cool, his collar glows in the dark.
This thing again. It's a different one. Someone had too much time on their hands.
Yeah. Hello, boy. Hello. Yeah, yeah. Okay.
How did it end up back here?
Oh, let's watch it.
There's a tape inside. Might as well see what's on it.
Yep, that's the way to do it. Red tapes allow you to manipulate reality. Pay attention to the environment and objects both around you and in the video. Fast forward, rewind, stop the video in key moments to change their states and positions. Oh. Oh. So the boy is playing with a toy car, and suddenly...
What the hell? This...
What the hell indeed?
This wasn't here a minute ago, right, buddy?
I don't think it was, no.
This tape... Did it just... No, that's not possible. Now get it together, Ellis.
What a fascinating way of playing with the Blair Witch sort of project as a sort of... concept in terms of like the movie, I guess, but also the fact that you had student filmmakers so using video cameras, this kind of thing, but also it's a brilliant gameplay mechanic.
It's probably Peters. Maybe Bullet can catch a scent.
Yeah, okay.
Come here, boy. You know what to do, buddy. Just like in training. Good boy. Now, you'd do great on the force if you weren't so stubborn. There's still some leftovers inside. Maybe a few days old.
Oh, come on, boy. Where have you gone? There you are. Thank goodness for that color. Yeah, okay. I'm coming. I'm not liking this. The other thing about growing up near woods, and also with all the stories that come out of North Wales, is that you definitely learn not to go into the woods in the dark. I mean, I went into the woods in the dark a few times when I was a teenager. I'd have to, you know, have to pass through the woods on my way home, but I was always uneasy.
Hey, buddy, what's wrong?
Because woodlands are, you know, dangerous places. What? What's wrong with it? Oh. Destroy.
It's definitely
okay.
Easy, boy. It's gone now.
Olga. Who's Olga? Blimey. Okay, boy. He wasn't happy about that, was he? Yeah, they're dangerous places, and I think the stories that surround forests, especially thick forests, are there essentially to keep you safe. Keep you away from falling into a pit and never being seen again. But yeah, there are, for example, fairies. You know, in actual folklore, fairies are terrifying creatures. I'm pretty sure I mentioned this in the Blair Witch video, so I won't go over retread that ground too much. But all manner of creepy things live in the forest, both in mythology, but also in many ways in real life. I'd say there are dangers, and I love the way this feels like that. Although this is worse, though, obviously, because there's just nothing. There's no, at least when I was going through the forest, there was some lights in the distance or something down by the coast, you know, in the valley. Here we're just in a hello, boy.
Still on track, buddy?
In a dark pit. Yeah, okay.
Pull it.
Tap, get walking.
Go ahead.
Go ahead. God damn it, Ellis. I've been trying to reach you for hours. First the kid, and now you. It's like the only thing I do is chase after whoever walks into this goddamn forest. Where the hell are you?
We went down a ravine and headed north, up to an old campsite.
Wait, what? We went through that area. We didn't find any campsite.
Well, you didn't find Peter's cap either. Listen, we're still on the trail. We'll keep moving north.
For Christ's sake, Ellis, stop playing a hero. Just sit your ass down till we find you.
Emmett, just find the campsite and head north. I'll look for a landmark, something to point you in the right direction.
Ellis.
I'll keep you posted. Over and out.
This is also reminding me of Doom 3 as well, actually. I remember that, where they could use the torch or the gun. Never both at the same time. Well, originally, I know they tweaked the game eventually, didn't they, to make it so you could use both. Having a drink? Good boy. Oh, man. We shouldn't be doing this. We should just hunker down, start a fire.
What is it, boy? Something wrong?
Get some sleep. What is it? Oh, that's another one of these things. Okay.
Weird.
Oh, God, that noise.
Man-made, but
Arthur.
What is it?
Oh, God, these are people in the corner of the basement. This is Rustin Parr. Oh, shoot. I'm not sure I want to be doing that. Okay. Incidentally, I can't promise I'll play the whole game today. Probably just an hour or so. Maybe an hour, maybe a couple of hours.
Bullet, what's wrong?
Oh.
Work, damn it!
Oh, no, work. I don't like this.
Get a grip, Ellis. It's just a tree.
It is just a tree.
Ellis to base. Near a dead white tree.
First dive.
Oh, great. He found a tree in a forest. Oh, Sheriff, this is a joke. I can't look for a kid, not this moron.
That's enough, Spencer.
Yeah,
Keep us posted, Ellis. Over and out.
Come on. Oh, no. This isn't the house, is it? Is this the house?
Phase 2, Ellis. I think we found the ravine you were talking about. Any updates on your side?
I should just head back to them, to where they are.
Base to Ellis, I repeat.
Yeah.
Ellis to base. Emmett, I just wanted to say, I know I screwed up, and I'm sorry.
I told you already, Ellis. What's done is done. No point in dwelling on the past. You found the kid's cap, you're still in one piece. And hey, at least we still got radio contact. All in all, could have been much worse.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. Thanks, Emmett. Over and out. Come here, boy.
What's this?
I guess we're not gonna find out.
Yeah. I mean, what are the odds of me being able to crack this safe? Is this then? This feels like a trench. One of my favorite stories from the forest involves someone who learns to play the violin, and they end up entertaining some sort of creepy fairies in the forest, in the woods, sort of fairies, imps, kind of, you know, general forest creatures, and they're convinced that they're in a lovely palace. And at the end of the evening, essentially,
not what I'd expect in the middle of the forest.
No.
Then again, I wouldn't expect reinforced concrete either.
No. Rednecks. At the end of the evening, it becomes clear
candy
that.
Candy wrapper. Really? Come on, Bullet. You can do better than that.
No, but the boys.
Go on. See if you can find something else.
There we go.
That's it. Take me to it.
At the end of the evening, it becomes clear, yeah, that you are basically on the menu. Or that you're the guy on the menu, the entertainer. And he escapes and then wakes up at the base of a giant tree that he thinks was the palace. Hallucinations in the dark.
There you go, buddy.
Forest
creatures. Oh, this
is
much better.
And,
let's see.
Be where you're not meant to be. Oh.
Wait. Is that?
There he is.
It's Peter.
I think I didn't see that, Peter. Ballsy move, kid.
Oh. Ballsy, indeed. Meant to be Rustin Parr has taken the boy.
Ellis to base. Peter didn't run away. He was kidnapped. I found a tape. It shows the man who did it.
What? How did... Wait, a tape? In the middle of the forest? Ellis, are you serious?
Yeah, those tapes, they make things appear, but... there's no time landing. We have to find the kid. He's in serious danger.
Ellis, even if that's true, I can't let you go alone.
We don't have much choice. Look, I won't do anything stupid. I'm just gonna find him and wait for you to catch up. Over and out.
No, Ellis, wait! God damn it!
I don't wait for him to get... I do wait for him to catch up.
He was shot in those trenches I saw earlier. Come on, Bullet. Let's check him out. The video was shot around here somewhere. There it is. Heel! Come on, boy. Peter's in danger, and we're the only ones who can help.
Oh, did they go down into the hole? No, they didn't go down there. Okay. But think about this, man. Think about it. Why would they be leaving tapes behind for you?
Go get
You're being led into a hell of your own making. I'm really not looking forward to meeting monsters and things. I really hope you don't actually meet the witch, though. That would be a shame if you actually saw. Yeah, again, as
you sure this is the right way, buddy?
As ever, seeing something is less scary than actually just knowing it's there.
Are we walking in circles, Bullet?
Oh. Like we are walking in circles. Hello, boy. Now this is clever as well, because the use of the dog, again, in terms of game design, means that you are inclined to just follow the path that they've laid out for you. Yeah, coming. I'm coming.
Bullet!
Oh, not the torch again.
Shoot. Where are you, buddy?
Where are you? Come on.
Come on, boy. Don't make me chase you. Bullet, where are you?
Oh no. Oh. This is really disorientating. This is, as they say, a little bit triggering. What have we seen? What have you seen? Oh shit!
What the hell?
Oh my. What the fuck? What the fuck? Oh.
What was that thing?
What was that thing indeed? Wow. Pay attention to Bullet's behavior. He's growling, will alarm you of danger, lurking in the dark. During a fight, keep him close, he'll locate enemies. But if left alone, will become vulnerable. Bloody hell. Well? I didn't like that. Oh, and another tape. See, look, they're playing with you, man. This is obvious. They're playing with you.
They think I don't know. But I see them. I see them. Whenever I wake them up, they stare at me. They follow me. The light keeps them away. Keeps me safe. Need to hold on to the light.
Okay. No. So I guess red tapes affect reality, blue tapes give you story and or hints. But interestingly, that was...
What is it, boy?
Oh. What have we found, boy? Under the one that... Oh, fuck. Where is it? Where are you, boy? Where are you? Oh, God, I can't see it. Where is it? Where are you? Where's the turret? Oh, there you are, there. Oh my. The thing is, though, I mean, that is unnerving and scary, but I imagine after a few exposures to that, you're going to get used to, you know, it's a bit like in Alien Isolation, where eventually, you know, you just go, okay, fine, whatever, I've been killed by the alien.
Oh, yeah, I gotta watch a step.
I don't like it. Where are you? Where's the bloody dog? There he is. Oh, I saw it. Where are you, boy? Okay, so one good solid torch shine on the monster makes it go away, I think. Maybe. But anyway, the point is, that isn't as scary as just having this thing stalking you and you never quite see it, but then reality itself is changing around you. So it's that's a,
huh?
But it's also a computer game, so you have to see something, I guess, don't you? It's a mixed bag, isn't it? Fallen tree. Oh, fallen tree.
Well, this tree seems familiar somehow.
Well, we've seen a tree fall in a previous video. Previous tape. Where are you, boy?
Come here, boy.
Where are you?
That's right. I saw it in the video.
Can he hear me? So let's see. Can we check our bag?
If I can make things appear, maybe I can make a move as well.
Is it in breadcrumb trail?
Let's see.
You think I didn't see that, Peter? Ballsy move, kid.
Yes, there we are. Cool. Did that work? Ah, it did. Excellent. I'm very happy with that. Where are you, boy? There you are. Hello. Hello, little man. Give you a bit of a...
Yeah, good dog.
Good dog indeed. So it's... It is scary, I guess, to have the monster there. It is definitely scary. I was, you know, undeniably scared.
Oh, hell. Maybe we could... God damn it. I was so close.
Ellis, answer me. Base to Ellis. Base to Ellis, I repeat. Base to Ellis.
Yeah, okay. Hello.
The white tree you were telling us about. I found it. It's really here.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Why wouldn't it be? Anyway, I'm nearby, so just wait for me there, okay? Let's go back, Bullet.
What's going to happen on the way back? But also, so just to finish that point before we get interrupted again, you have to have the monster there, I guess, as a game, for a game player to react to. In so much as in a movie, you can have the actors reacting to the supernatural. In the game, you can't. But at the same time as well, for the story to make sense and for the lore to make sense, Ellis isn't really commenting on the monsters. He's not really, for example, telling the police sergeant or chief what he's seen. Possibly because of his PTSD, he doesn't want people to think he's going crazy in the woods, but it leads to, I guess, a slight inconsistency in how people would respond. Where are we going? Oh, am I leading now? Okay. I think I know the way back. Do I know the way back? Now, this is something that Bloober team are very good at in, for example, Layers of Fear, is playing with your sense of direction. I mean, just then when we were getting lost, and I was losing whereabouts the dog was in relation to me, that was a little less subtle because there were little cuts and jumps between short walking sections. But, for example, in Layers of Fear, you know, or actually they've also done it recently in Jedi Fallen Order at times. Can be going in one direction, think you know what's behind you, then turn around and what's behind you suddenly changes. And that's something that you can do in a computer game to great effect. Oh man, the quietness of the woods, the way the light shines on the foliage and highlights certain trees, and beautiful. I mean, beautifully grim, but again, very evocative, very reminiscent.
Bullet!
Of real world forests and woodland.
Here!
Oh, yeah, there you are. Okay. Where are we going? Oh, I hear that. I hear that. Oh no, we're meant to be coming back here, aren't we? Yeah. And then we need to go to the white tree. Where's the white tree in relation to this? We came at the car from this direction. So the white tree will be this way? Or that way? This way, yeah, because you've got the trench. Now, I guess the question is, hopefully the police guys are going to be there, because, I mean, or are they going to be there in a different time? Because the witch obviously plays with time and space. Are we even talking to each other at the same time? Is it night time for those guys? Because they were saying they didn't want to be in the forest at night, weren't they, at the beginning of the game? The police. Oh, well, they're not here. They are not here.
Ellis to base.
And the ground is glowing strangely.
Landing, where are you?
Still under the tree.
What, but... So am I.
What? Are we talking about the same tree? White, leafless, black vines all over?
Yeah, that's the one.
Well, look, this doesn't make sense. All of this. It's just ridiculous. God damn it, Ellis. It was a mistake letting you come here. You wanted to redeem yourself. I get it. And I wanted to help, but this is too much for you. You're not thinking straight.
Hey, don't talk to me like I'm crazy.
Well, what do you want me to say, Ellis? That it's all fine and dandy? Because I sure as hell tried that, and it didn't work.
Screw you, Emmett. I don't need your help. No, it's you who needs me. Now, I'm the only person in this goddamn forest who is even remotely close to finding that kid. Emmett.
Ugh.
You there?
Gross. Don't sit on that boy.
God damn it.
It's not good.
Where's the boy?
Oh. What's he growling at? Okay. Where is it? There it is. We got it. Oh. Where'd it go? There it is. Okay. Oh, there it is. I quite like the way it sort of jiggles behind trees. There it is. Got it. Where is it? Okay, it's gone. And you see, that's precisely it. It is so much easier to deal with as time goes on, because you understand what you have to do, you have to find the thing, the torch lights up, and it jiggles a bit, and it goes away, and... Whereas actually that is far more creepy, going to the tree, both of you apparently are there, but you're not there. I mean, I was hoping that sort of thing would happen, and it did. But I guess that's more subtle. I didn't jump and... Yeah, scream shit.
Wait.
That did I? Where are we going? I have no idea where to go next. Back there we have an abandoned car. Over there we have a tree covered in mank. And down here we have a door.
Wait here, buddy.
Got a locked padlock. Try that? No. I mean, it's going to be loads of different combinations. I remember when I first played Resident Evil 2, just guessing a combination for a... It was in the... the demo in their remake. That was pretty cool. So that's going to be... Okay. Which way do you think, boy? Which way? Well, we were sent this way. Let's go back. Let's see if we can find... some monkey tree. Oh, hang on. No way, man. We walked all day just to end up back at the same freaking place. No. That's pretty cool, though. There you go, Bloober Team. That's what we wanted. That's what I wanted. I wanted you to mess with my sense of direction. So here I am back at the bridge. I don't know how, but I am. I mean, this just feels so wrong, incidentally, as well. Again, if you grow up near woodlands and forest, you just don't do this. There's no trail, you've got no sense of direction. All you've got is leaves blocking your view. And essentially, you're having your vision obscured by light in that sense as well. Because you can't see as far that far. Because things are highlighted by the light. Feels so wrong. Why am I doing this? Well, I know why I'm doing it. Just to see what happens. Okay. Now, interestingly, I can't go any... Oh, I can. Okay. Where are we? Police car.
Wait. Isn't that... It's Lanning's car. But how? It was a complete wreck just a moment ago.
Goodness.
Come in, Emmett. I know you're there. I just found your car. Come on, Emmett. Talk to me.
Fuck. Channel 3.
The light.
Channel 3, say the light.
Come here, boy.
Well, can I get my...
Say, the light. Huh.
Channel 3.
The light?
Turn on the lights.
What?
The headlights. Turn them on.
That's what? Me.
Who is this? Hello? Yeah, why the hell not?
That's me. That was me. Okay, well...
Locked, of course.
Smash the fucking window at this point, then. Wouldn't you?
Hey, who?
You found...
Where'd you find him?
Oh, good job.
Like it matters. No, good job, buddy.
Good boy. Okay, well. I like the police speed count scanner there.
Stay here, boy.
What's gonna happen when I turn on the lights? What's gonna happen when I turn on the lights? Come on. And is that the lights? That's the choke, isn't it?
No battery.
Of course there's no battery. Fuse panel. Okay. Front light 20 amps.
I should take a look under the hood.
Oh, is that... I thought that was next to the steering wheel for some reason.
Another missing person?
Mr. Wilson has notified the disappearance of Todd McKinnon by Adam Brown. According to his testimony, McKinnon was supplying him with timber, but he suddenly stopped about 2 weeks ago. Brown was unable to establish any form of contact with McKinnon. The initial search yielded no results. McKinnon could not have been found in his home. McKinnon has no history of mental health problems. Currently examined hypothesis, deliberate disappearance. Blimey. McKinnon's neighbours claim that he was frequently visiting the defunct sawmill east of Tappy, sawmill off Tappy East Creek Timber Company in the Black Hills Forest. Tappy Creek, I think, turns off near the beginning of the Blair Witch Project. It's where the two guys are fishing, I think. Okay, right. Let's... Oh, God, I hate this, right? Okay. I hate it, but I love it. That's why I keep coming back to these games like this. Okay, man. There's the headlights. Now what?
I see. That's an interesting idea. But, John, with your long and, dare I say, fruitful career as a film critic, why has this particular movie become such an obsession for you?
Well, how could it not? Even the shortest description sounds eerie. An obscure black and white documentary shot in various mental asylums.
Yeah, and as we all know, mental care in the 60s wasn't exactly top-notch.
Oh, it certainly wasn't. One might even go so far as to call it atrocious, and that is precisely what this movie shows. The macabre treatment of patients in these institutions. Now, it goes without saying, the film is not for the faint of heart. The force-feeding scene is particularly hard to sit through. We watch as a tube is inserted through the patient's nostril, all the way down his throat. A nutrient liquid is then pumped straight into his stomach.
Is this a reference to Blair Witch 2? Book of
awful.
Shadows? The opening, some of the flashback scenes in that?
That's precisely why everyone should watch it. Remember, 1 in 20 people will spend some part of their life in a mental institution. Who knows? Maybe it's you. Good night.
Greetings, my beloved listeners. I'm so glad you could join me on this very special night. Do you know what time it is? That's right. It's time for our annual trivia challenge. Today's question is...
What have you done, Alice?
Oh, looks like we have a winner. It's someone who knows the answer all too well. Congratulations. Your prize is on its way. Good night.
Okay, thank you. And the bonnet's still open. Oh, I need to check my phone. Come on. Check my phone. Okay.
Message. But there's no reception.
The prize. Oh no. Okay, here we go. 11:42. Moving is always better than standing.
Not making any damn sense.
Don't move at 99% higher chance of dying. I just start walking. Oh, blimey. Okay.
What the?
The prize, that's your padlock. Padlock combination. Nice. Turn on the headlights. Close the bonnet.
Stay here, boy.
Why can't we get in the car with us? Ah, there we go.
Blown
okay.
Fuses. That explains it.
Front lights 7. Okay. We need a 20 amp fuse. Instrumental control module. Cigarette lighter is 6. I'm going to put that
looks good.
Okay. Is that the light? Is that the lights? Oh. What the hell?
But how?
What the hell? Now that, interestingly, that's actually quite evocative.
I'm really losing it this time, aren't I? Yeah, my thoughts exactly.
Of the Blair Witch, at the end when you see, in the house, the daylight suddenly changing outside. Some people have said, oh, it's like it's an alien, like a UFO landing, which I think is nonsense. I think it's basically the witch is just changing day to night, in rapid succession. And you just managed to do it with a car. With a headlight switch in a car. We have been here before, I think. Hello, boy. At 1:57. Anyway, I was just calling to her. I don't know why, really. Been thinking a lot about us lately. Still avoiding me running around the woods. Anyway, I was just calling her. Bye, call me when you can. The hospital just let you know. I think about it, doctor. Hello, let's make you appointment. Then. It's 1:57 in the afternoon.
Isn't it
the afternoon
early for you?
No. Why would it be? You don't want to talk?
No. It's good to hear your voice. Listen, I'm sorry about before. Seems all I do is apologize, and then I say something stupid again.
Yeah, and I keep coming back for more. Guess I'm a glutton for punishment.
It's like we're trapped in a never-ending cycle of bullshit.
You tell me about
a
it.
A perpetual bullshit machine. They should hook us up to the grid. We could probably power up a small city.
Hey, as long as we're getting paid. We were good for a while, weren't we?
Yeah, I guess we were.
So, what happened? Yeah. Mine more than yours.
Hey, don't beat yourself up. You got a job to do, remember?
Yeah. I better get to it. I'll call you later, okay?
I'll hold you to it.
So we're at the creek. Well, I better put my torch away. Don't need that, because it's the, middle of the day at 1:57. Because 0:157, of course, would be middle of the night, not the afternoon.
But stay.
And, just come back. Hello.
Aren't you a handsome boy?
Here we go.
Oh, God, it's freezing. It's better be worth it.
Unending forest. Stuff of dreams and nightmares. Let's see.
Come here, boy.
What did you find? Actually,
Peters.
It's a toy or something. It's a bit grim. Could be something like a... Sounds like something from Silent Hill or Resident Evil. I like the minimalist music as well. I mean, that's been obviously used to great effect to make me jump in the air, but every now and then. What's up? What's up, boy?
Two sets of footprints. Both heavy set. Male. One's barefoot. Odd. Smoker, huh?
On the beach.
Well, if I don't get you, they sure will.
They were my cigarette. I had some of those cigarettes on my dashboard in the car. Right at the beginning, I seem to recall.
What is it, Bullet? What'd you find?
What did you find?
All right, good boy, good boy. Now move aside.
Okay. Okay. Oh, I'm not gonna like this.
I don't like it either. Let me take a look and we'll be on. Jesus Christ! Fuck!
Blood?
Can't be it. Emmett!
Oh my God.
We were just... I don't understand. Emmett. Oh God. Fuck. Lanning. Oh God. Look, you know, you deserve better than this.
Okay.
Lenning's badge. Oh, no one deserved it more than him.
He's missing some teeth. It's like he's been maybe gnawed on.
Neck wound. Deep. And his head is... Oh God, it's barely hanging on. Ugh. The killer... Oh, skinned his face. Clean cuts. Probably post-mortem. Completely different MO than the decapitation wound.
Did I see a spade on the floor there? Or... Oh, there's a photo.
Lanning was tough, experienced. He wouldn't let a killer surprise him. It had to be someone he knew. Another one. Wonder who those people are.
Please tell me I didn't do this. In that lost. Time. Ugh, okay. Okay. Oh, look at the mist gathering in the hollow. That's nice and creepy. Okay, let's watch the tape, shall we?
I miss anything.
What were you doing here, Sheriff? This is no longer just a missing person case. Come on, Bullet. We gotta finish this. Sheriff Emmett Lanning. The guy who cared about everything and everyone. Even me. You know, we really saw eye to eye, but never gave up. Not even after letting down. Rest easy, Emmett. I'll find the man who did this.
Speed.
It's the shovel from the video. I'll get him for this, Lanning. I swear.
Okay. Oh. No, 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 no. What? That night vision. Where's the dog? Oh, God. Oh, phew. Okay. That is, it's night vision on the camera. Ugh. Oh, yeah, infrared. Okay. What have you found? Oh, whoa, whoa. Feels like the game's glitching, but...
Wait, what? Where'd all the water go? Is this really the right way back? Either I'm going crazy or...
meant to be happening. What is going on? So have I killed the police chief and now I'm running away from the search team and them finding?
Oh man! Oh oh!
To me, Alice.
Oh. Okay. In the woods like that. Like at this point, wouldn't you'd be going,
"No, not now.
This isn't real."
Come on, work.
Please work. Please work. Oh, I see, and now we're in pitch black and all we have is a night vision screen to help us. Okay, well, let's see what happens, I guess. I have no idea where I'm going. Oh, I see, so there's just about something on the screen. Oh, there's the dog, okay. Hello, Bullet. Hello, boy.
I hope you know where you're going, boy.
Me too. At this point, you're hallucinating that much, you're seeing red and black flashes and weird black streaks on, you know, in your vision, and you hear a voice saying, "Come to me, Alice," then surely to goodness she was
distracted. Or a warning.
Probably both. You'd be questioning your own sanity, wouldn't you? You'd be like, this really happening? Sweetheart. I can't see anything. It's me incidentally calling out to him, i.e. pressing the button to do that. That's not just the game doing it. Well, all I can see is through this little screen. It'd be nice if I could hold it a bit closer up to my eye, you know. Oh man, the sound effects are brilliant. Progress? Hard to know for sure. I see my own feet on the ground. But also, why isn't Ellis commenting on that, on hearing that voice, I wonder? Again, it's one of those things where the needs of a computer game are overriding. Why isn't he going, what the hell is that? Distortion there happening on the screen. Oh. I mean, obviously, if this was happening to me in real life, I would just be losing my mind. I would be very scared. Oh, is that a shape in the dark over there? Is that a way out?
Bullet?
Bullet, where are you?
Bullet.
Dark Descent or something.
Wolf!
Oh. Oh. Oh.
Oh my god.
Yeah, why didn't you get your torch out, man? Use your torch. Photo. Of course, need to look at it. Nondescript. Okay. Thanks for that. Thanks for wasting my time.
Over here.
You just wouldn't, would you? You just would not. I'd be like, no, no. Not coming over there. Whoever you are.
Bullet, where are you?
Let's check my phone. Okay, messages. I have a new voice message. It's 3:33 now. Blimey heck. Okay. Phone book, voicemail. 3:33. The witching hour, according to some.
You have one new message.
Mm-hmm.
Sierra, Hotel, Echo, Inferno, Slaughter.
Nice. Got a torch out, I think. No signal, but I got a voicemail, apparently. That's not messed up at all.
You came to your senses.
Whose senses? Who's speaking? Why am I speaking and why isn't Alice speaking? Okay. Okay. Oh, that skull. Oh, nice. Oh, very nice. Mmm. A skull and a helmet, perhaps.
My Alice. Forever mine.
Shit.
Shit indeed.
Oh.
So who's that?
Off the record, Alice. What the hell happened? You responded to a robbery call. When you got there, you saw them leaving the store. You took out your gun. You told them to stop. The kid reached for something. Was it a weapon?
No.
And then what?
Well, you know what happened. This is on me. Adam Shannon. Peter's brother.
Oh, no.
I don't know what I was thinking. I was the last person he'd want to see.
Oh.
For all I knew, I could have crippled him for life. And yet, I felt it was something I had to do. Had to, but couldn't.
Wow. Cool imagery. Bodies piling up. So are you you're a veteran, I guess, and a police officer who's seen some stuff. That lady that we keep seeing, those eyes, I wonder. Could that be Jess?
Yeah, how did we end up back here?
Yeah, indeed, yeah. Yes, how the hell did we end up back here? I didn't even know this was here. I feel like
I know.
A little nest now in there.
Looks the same, but
older.
Older. It's a lot older. Oh, this doesn't make any sense.
What are you telling me? Oh, that's another red tape. Whew. Okay, well, I've been playing for an hour and a half now. I think I'm gonna leave it there. Let's get rid of this thing though. Let's poor Bullet, very happy.
Easy boy, it's gone now.
There you go. Marius. Come here,
Bullet.
Come back here. And I guess next time I'll be looking at that tape. If you guys want to see a part two, let me know. I will definitely do a part two. I know it's not the most Christmassy thing to be doing. And in fact, later this week, I plan on doing a little treat of a video, treat for you and me, in fact, because something came back into my life, which I'm very happy about. By then, the office will be nicely decorated as well. So I just couldn't quite bring myself to get Christmassy before the general election. Yep, I hate to say it. Tomorrow we're voting in this country, and it's going to be interesting, to say the least.
Another one.
Yeah. Very female figure, that one. I guess they've all been sort of female. Let's see what. Let's have a look at that. Read that document. Yeah, we've already seen that one. What's the most recent document? Okay, maybe I... Oh no, there you go. Most recent document. Fear of forgetting critters. Theodore McKinnon, my father, was a lumberjack. When I was a child, he would often take me to the sawmill in the Black Hills Forest to tell me stories of the monsters and witches, or witch, who lived there. I returned to that place after almost 40 years. It looked exactly how I remembered, except for its haunting emptiness. Now no one was telling the stories of fearsome critters anymore. There was not a single soul to pass the legends on. The logging company disbanded, and the old sawmill was left to rot. But I could not simply let it be forgotten, not before it revealed its secrets to me, not before I learned what drove my father to take his own life. I think we're going to be visiting a sawmill in the near future. Also, look, it's sort of autumny, the leaves are falling. Slight snow, actually. Again, well done, Blue Team. This feels like a forest. However, despite the, Man, I didn't even see these, to quote Josh. Oh. Okay, yes, I'm going to leave it here for today. If you want to see a part two, let me know. I'll happily come back to it. Even though it's December. I mean, frankly, any excuse to play a scary game, I don't mind. As ever, guys, until next time, do take care. And, here's hoping that I don't have nightmares. Bye-bye.